Hello, everyone. Welcome. Thanks for being here today. Hello, from New York City, and welcome back to Uncle Julie's Kids Trivia Show. If you're online, send me a quick message so that I know you are here. People are texting me, and I want them to know that they should just come to this page. If you're here, send me a quick message to let me know that you are here. All right, Chris O'Donnell, Joseph Kalari. Oh, there we go. Our show has begun. I am Uncle Julie, and you can call me Uncle Julie, even if I'm not really your uncle. Now, we got some great feedback last night from parents all over the country. And so today, I'm doing two shows. The first is now for kids ages 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And the second starts at 6:15 p.m. Eastern for ages 9 and above and their parents. Now, this is not a hard rule. So if you are 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8, you can stay online as long as it's okay with your parents. And if you're 9 or above, you're welcome to join the fun now. Now, we'll have 5 questions now, and then at 6:15, we'll start with 10 questions. So tonight, you can get up to 15 points. You get 1 point for each correct answer, and you keep track of your points on your own. And remember the honor system. Okay, before we begin, I am gonna take off my sweater and get more comfortable. You get more comfortable and get ready for some trivia. So if you've got a pad and a paper, you can write, a pad and pen, you can write everything that I say, or you can write your answers down. Not everything that I say, that would be a lot to write down. You can write down your answers, or you can put them right into Facebook and I can see them on my screen. Either way. Okay, every show starts with a deep breath because we're all experiencing some things now that are new and different. So a deep breath helps us stay calm and focused. All right, everyone who's watching, and I see a whole bunch of people watching on my screen. Hands on your tummy, eyes closed. Oh, that feels good. Oh, I want to introduce you. There's a lot of people texting, but I can't turn it off or you're not going to hear the fun audio later. So here's Lizard. This is my lizard. Last night, on last night's show, we got a really cool name for him. So please meet my new friend, Lizardo Da Vinci. I have to say it the Italian way. Lizardo Da Vinci. Can you say his name in Italian, boys and girls? Lizardo Da Vinci. All right, Lizardo is gonna sit right here on my desk. I also have my special lemonade because that's what this show is all about, taking lemons and turning them into lemonade. So all the parents out there, you can bring your special lemonade to the show too, because I know it's been a long day homeschooling. All right, let's see who's here. Who we got here? Hello. Oh, Elena Jacobson, Nico. Hey, Nico from LA, hello. Oh, Ellison is online. I heard Ellison was bored today, so I'm glad that he's here. Jack and Antonio. Hey, Patrick Graham and Laura. That means Skylar's here as well. Awesome. Jack Lucevero. Hey, I haven't seen you in years. The Lambs are here. What up, Nathaniel and Molly and Tallulah? I also think we have Booker watching from Dobbs Ferry, New York. Bobby Kleinow and our friends from Staten Island. Look at this. Oh, our Fairhaven friends are here too. So exciting. Okay, so I'm gonna mute this little button here. Oh, I can't because I'm the only person here. So one day someone else will do that for me. All of our videos are gonna get saved to this page. So you can hit share and share it with your friends afterward. And I would love that. All right, everybody ready? Let's make some lemonade, people. All right, question number one. Question one. What is the name of the planet we live on? Now, for the adults who are tuning in, the first five questions are just for kids ages 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So they might seem a little easy for you. What is the name of the planet we live on? You'll have 20 seconds to answer. Is it Earth, Mars, or the Moon? And 20 seconds are on the clock. 20 seconds are on the clock. 20 seconds are on the clock. 12, 11, 10. Lizardo is watching you. Lizardo wants to make sure you're writing down your answer. 3, 2, 1. All right, so our first answer is Earth. A, Earth. We live on planet Earth. So if you wrote down Earth, you get 1 point. Fantastic work. All right, let's move on. You know what? Hold on 1 second. I can do my own tech. Look at that. Uncle Julie, you're a whiz. All right, let's move on to question number two. Question two. Oh, that's coming from there. So much audio. If you freeze water, what do you get? If you freeze water, what do you get? All right, do you get A, chocolate, B, ice, or C, rain? Do you get chocolate, ice, or rain? You have 20 seconds to answer. Just so everyone else knows, when the questions start at 6:15, we'll only have 10 seconds to answer. So what do we got? Oh, there's a lot of answers for ice. A lot of answers for ice. We got 2, 2, 1, 2. Oh, there we go. 3, 2, 1. And the answer is ice. Yeah. What is, if you freeze water, what do you get? You get ice. So you also get 1 point if you answered correctly. All right, let's move on to question number three. We've got 70 computers logged into this right now, which means there's at least like 200 people watching with all of you kids sitting at home. This is exciting. All right, moving on to question number three. Question three, who was the first president of the United States of America? Okay, ages 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Do you know the answer? You've got 20 seconds on the clock. Anna Malley, if you're reporting in from Tiburon, California, I hope you know the answer. Who else knows? Oh, it's Eco and Marina and family from Virginia. Hey, everybody. All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Who was the first president of the United States? Let's see. Oh, you had choices to pick from. This is what it looks like when you improv a TV show, everybody. Was it Thomas Jefferson, George Washington, or Abraham Lincoln? I'll give you a few more seconds if you want. I'm gonna scroll through these comments and say hi to people. Oh, hey, look, Kaya's here, yes. Hello and welcome. Okay, hi. We've got the answer. This question is George Washington. George Washington was the first president of the United States of America. Well done if you got that. And if you got it right, you get 1 point. All right, let's see if we've got, here we go. Question four. Oh, let's break for just a second. My nephew Nicholas said that Lincoln was the 16th. Well, thank you, Nikki. I know you're home in New Jersey. I can't wait to give you a big hug when this special time is over in our country and we're gonna give hugs and kisses and it's gonna be amazing. All right, great. Hey, Jen San Martino and Deb Falcone. All right, question four, here we go. What color is a frog usually? Now, what does the word usually mean? Usually means most of the time, ordinarily, right? So if you see, let's say, 100 frogs, many of them would be this color. So Nathaniel, I know you're watching. Nathaniel Lamb, I got to make sure that you get this right. Let's see. Is it red? Is it blue? Or is it green? Which one is it? You've got 20 seconds on the clock. 20 seconds while Uncle Julie has a little bit more of his lemonade. All right, there we go. Now, who sent me that face? Oh, there's some laughing faces. That's exciting. All right, great. Is it red, blue, or is it green? 1 second left on the clock. It is green. Most frogs are green. Usually frogs are green. So there you go. If you wrote down green, then you get 1 point. Awesome. Hey, everybody, we're at 77 computers logged in. There's like so many people watching. This is pretty great. We're going to do this every Monday through Friday at 6 o'clock for ages 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then the 9-year-olds and their parents will join at 6:15. Why? Because, you know, we all need a little consistency in this new special time, right? So here we go. We are at the frog. All right, question 5. If you're just joining us, not to worry. We have 10 questions starting in 3 or 4 minutes. Question 5. Here we go. Let's see what it is. What season is missing from this list? Spring, fall, summer. What season is missing from this list? Spring, fall, summer. Is it fall, winter, or October? Which season was missing? Think about it. You can type your answers in or you can write them on a piece of paper. Some of us are sharing computers and it's not necessary for you to chat it in, but you're more than welcome because I love seeing your name pop up. All right, great. All right, Joe Calari, it's not easy being green. No, it's not. All right, everybody. What season was missing from the list? We had spring, fall, summer. The season missing is B, winter. B, winter. Winter was missing from the list. All right, everybody. So that's our trivia for tonight for our ages 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now we're going to move on to our 9-year-olds and above with 10 trivia questions. Now, before we do that, a few things. I want to say hello to our home together pals. We are all home together. So, who are our home together pals tonight? Let's take a look. We've got Joe and Anthony and Nikki in Monroe, New Jersey. Hello, Joe and Anthony and Nikki. These are my nephews out in Monroe, New Jersey. All right, that's a picture of them last night playing Uncle Julie's Kids Trivia Show. All right, who else we got? Vivian. Hey, Viv. This is my niece, Vivian. Isn't Vivian awesome? She's in Union, New Jersey, hanging out, watching the show tonight. Hi, Vivian, sending love. All right, who else do we have tonight from our home together pals? We've got Joey and Eddie watching from Manhattan, New York. Joey and Eddie, that's Joey with his dad, Jim, watching our show last night on his phone. We've got Sam from Fairhaven, New Jersey. There he is last night watching Uncle Julie's Kids Trivia Show. How do you know that this is a different show than last night? That's a blue tie. This is a red one. New day. All right, everybody. Who else is in our home together pals tonight? We've got Anna. Hey, Anna in Tiburon, California. Anna Malley. Watching Uncle Julie at her laptop. So exciting. Well, I'm so glad that you all joined tonight, and I'm so glad that you were our home together pals. If you have a picture of you watching the show, have your parents send it to me, and we'll feature it tomorrow night. And if it's your birthday, let me know. because no one should celebrate their birthday with only the family in their house. So if you have a birthday coming up on Uncle Julie's show, I will make sure we celebrate it. Let me know. All right, it's 6:15. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Uncle Julie's Kids Trivia Show. For ages 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, we've done their trivia already, and this seems like a pretty viable new format. All right, so let's jump in. We're going to start every show with a deep breath. Now, I know some of you who are here at 6 are like, I got to take another deep breath. Yes, because we're all experiencing lots of things every day now that are new and different and might feel a little strange to us. So I want to make sure that everyone who's connected right now, over 200, 300 people, are taking a nice deep breath. Ready? Hands, eyes. Great. Okay, I want to introduce you also to my lizard. Some of you met him a few minutes ago. Last night, Christian Rouleau, my college friend from Harvard, his children named this lizard Leonardo da Vinci. So this is Leonardo da Vinci, everybody. He'll be here. So will it, my lemonade. Cheers to all of you parents who made it through your new year. Cheers to all you parents who made it through your homeschool day. All right, let's make some lemonade, people. Our trivia continues. All right, everybody, here we go. Oh, wait, our riddle from last night. What travels around the world without leaving its corner? If this is new to you, think about it. Let's see if you have the answer. It was our riddle from last night. Every night we're gonna have a riddle. Last night's riddle was, what travels all around the world without leaving its corner? The answer, a stamp. That's right, the answer was a stamp. Now, couple of rules. You can write down your answers. You can plug them into Facebook. Either way, sounds good to me. But we're doing this on the honor system, right? We're going to restore some honor to the way that we behave in this country. And we're going to start right here on Uncle Julie's Trivia Show. All right. So question one is a science question. Science question. Yay for science, because science is saving our butts right now. So, question one is a science question, and let's take a look at what it is. What planet is closest to the sun? What planet is closest to the sun? Is it Venus, Mercury, or Earth? Which planet is closest to the sun? Now, for the 9-year-olds and the adults, you only get 10 seconds to log your answer. That's it. 10 seconds are up. What planet is closest to the sun? Venus, Mercury, or Earth? It is, in fact, Mercury. Here, if you haven't seen this since the 4th or 5th grade, welcome. And if you're in the 4th or 5th grade, you've seen this recently. Mercury, Venus, Earth. Also called the third rock from the sun, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto. Now, there's a lot of debate as to whether these two are really the last two in that order, but tonight's not about debate, is it? It's about trivia, it's about family, it's about friends, it's about coming together, and it's about lemonade. All right, everybody. Eddie Monahan just joined us. Fantastic. You know who else is on the line tonight? Owen Vaccaro. Owen Vaccaro and friends and family in Atlanta, Georgia. Welcome to the show. Owen is a really great friend of mine who is in a movie I just made, but we'll talk about that another time. Sending love to all of you in the ATL. All right, everybody. So here we go. Venus and Mercury, Earth, and where's my cursor? Okay, there we go. So we've got question two is our animal question. What is the name of this animal? Take a look. Take a look. What is the name of this animal? Now, I am getting messages that tell me that Pluto is no longer a planet. Thank you for the updates, everybody. Totally understand. All right, so what animal is this animal? Hey, Lori Desideric and everybody from Long Island. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay, what animal is this animal? Is it a giraffe, a stork, or a flamingo? You have 7 seconds already because I started talking and then I put the timer on. 4, 3, 2, 1. What animal is it? It is a flamingo. This is a flamingo and that's a stork. Flamingo, stork. Flamingo, stork. Flamingo, stork. If you put down flamingo, you get 1 point. Awesome. Moving on. Question 3 is our history question. History is really important. If you study history, hopefully you won't repeat it. All right, everybody. So question 3 is our history question. Who was the only president elected unanimously? Who was the only president elected unanimously? What does unanimously mean? It means that everyone who was voting voted for the same person. It means everyone who was voting for the same person. Was it George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, or Donald Trump? Who was it? You have 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Who was the only US president ever elected unanimously? The answer, my friends, my family, my loves, George Washington. In case you're wondering, the first US presidential election was held over a period of weeks from December 1788 to January 1789. George Washington was elected with 69 of the first round votes cast in the United States Electoral College. He won 69 of 69 and became the only US president ever to be unanimously chosen. Isn't that kind of cool info? I love that. All right, moving on, everybody. Question 4 is our sports question. Now, anyone who knows Uncle Julie knows Uncle Julie knows nothing about sports, but luckily, Google does. All right, everybody. Sports question number 4. Who won the Super Bowl in 2017? Who won the Super Bowl in 2017? Take a look. You got 10 seconds on the clock. Here we go. Oh, look. Miss Wheatley's here. How are you? Sending love from an apartment in which I am solo for the next and foreseeable future. All right, everybody, who won the Super Bowl in 2017? It was, oh, you had choices. Who knew? Patriots, Falcons, or Eagles? Was it the Patriots, the Falcons, or the Eagles? I'll give you 5 more seconds if you want these choices. Patriots, Falcons, or Eagles? Who won the Super Bowl in 2017? It was, in fact, the New England Patriots. All right, everybody, that was the answer. So if you got it correct, you get 1 point. Moving on to question 5. Every night we'll have an arts question, because if we're going to have a sports question, Uncle Julie wants an arts question. All right, everybody. So arts question tonight is, where is the musical The Phantom of the Opera set? Have you seen a musical? Have you been to Broadway? Right now, Broadway is closed, but it's going to reopen, and I want you to go see the whatever is the big show now, right? Where is the musical The Phantom of the Opera set? Do we have any answers coming in over Facebook? Let's see. Daily Double, Jen Barbera wants it. Oh, Teresa Pelosi says, I don't know. All right, everybody. Erica and family say Paris. Susie Gilbert says in a theater. That's interesting. Well, you know what? I'm going to give you choices. So was it Berlin? Was it Madrid? Or was it Paris? Was it Berlin, Madrid, or Paris? Berlin, Madrid, or Paris? Go ahead. Here we are, making a lemonade out of lemons. All right. It was, in fact, Paris. The Phantom of the Opera was set in Paris in a theater palace. In Paris. All right, everybody. Moving on to question six. This is our parent question. That means if you're watching without your parents, call them over to join us. And if you're watching with your parents, the answer probably lies with them. All right, here's our parent question, everybody. Oh, Mike Lamb said, we said Notre Dame. That's a pretty good one, actually. But you don't get any points tonight. All right, everybody. So, parent question, here we go. What famous singer released the song I Will Survive in 1978? Now, I'm not going to give you any options on this one. What song? Oh, there she is. What singer released? That's what happens when you make a show by yourself. All right, everybody. This is our singer. I don't know her name. Do you? I Will Survive, and that was Gloria Gaynor with some very prescient words for us. As long as I know how to love, I know I will survive. So, in the middle of homeschooling, maybe Gloria Gaynor's words can help you. As long as I know how to love, I know I will survive. All right, everybody, that was Gloria Gaynor. So, if you came up with the right answer, you get a point. All right, making our own show. Here we go. Question seven, body math, body math, body math. This is body math. All you need is a body and a basic understanding of mathematics. Body math. Ready, everybody? Here we go. What is the number of hearts you have plus the number of toes you have plus the number of elbows, all of that multiplied by the number of legs? Okay, you've got to do this math really quickly. This is for you, lambs. I know you love math. Right, Uncle Mike? You're Uncle Mike now, since I'm Uncle Julie. Okay, everybody, the number of hearts plus the number of toes plus the number of elbows times the number of legs. What have we got here, everybody? We got 10 seconds left. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. I'm getting a lot of angry faces from parents who are like, I've had enough math all day. All right, everybody. So it is 26. How do we get that number? We've got one heart, 10 toes, 2 elbows, and 2 legs. So we've got 1 plus 10 is 11, plus 2 is 13. All of that times 2 is 26. There we go. Who got it? Who got it? Who got it? Oh, who got it? Well, Marie Belusky Carbonetto got it. And Lauren Grossman and her family down south got it. Who else? Jen Barber, Mike Rubenfeld's family got it. Nice work, everybody. The Seaworks on Staten Island got it. The Gilberts in Fairhaven, well done. All right, everybody, that was question 8. Moving on. Oh, this is question 8. This is our movie question. Okay, tonight's movie question is... what character in the movie Frozen has sticks for arms? snaps. What character in the movie Frozen has sticks for arms? You get no choices from me. You got to come up with it by yourself. I'm going to have some lemonade while you think on it. I'm noticing it's a little dark in here. I am being lit by the beautiful sun in New York City. So some nights will be dark and some nights will be brighter. And isn't that just how it's going to go from now on? And that's okay. All right, everybody. Math joke. Yep, totally. What character? There he is. That's Olaf. He's the answer. Olaf is the answer. If you got Olaf and you said Olaf, you get 1 point. All right. Question number 9 is Mrs. Crane's vocabulary question. Mrs. Crane was my middle school and high school English teacher and a very good friend of mine. And these are from her vocabulary list. All right, everybody. If someone informs you of something, what does that mean? If someone informs you of something, what does that mean? Does it mean they lie to you? Does it mean they tell you? Or does it mean they ask you a question? Does it mean they lie to you? Does it mean they tell you? Or does it mean they ask you a question? What does the word informs mean? You have 10 seconds on the clock, everybody. Log your answer, put it down on paper, commit to it, put it into Facebook, however you want. The correct spelling of Olaf, just so you know, is O-L-A-F. All right, 1 second left, and inform means to tell you. Okay, great, everybody. That means that B was correct. So if you answered B, then you get a point. All right, Joanna Santori wants to know if this is limoncello. This is lemonade, and this is lemonade made from lemons, which is what we're doing here on this show. All right, everybody, so let's move on to question 10. Question 10, every night is an awesome woman. It's an awesome woman. Why? Because I was raised by an awesome woman, and I've got 2 sisters who are awesome women, and on this show, we're gonna celebrate awesome women. So question 10 is, who is this awesome woman? Take a look. I'm not gonna give you any options. Take a look. Let's see if we've got any answers coming in. Let's see. Eileen, I love my lemonade. That's right. Okay, let's see. Anyone? Who is this woman? All right, so let's see if we have any clues here. Owen Vaccaro for the win. Well done. That is Martin Luther King. This is clearly a picture from the civil rights era. This is a woman named Rosa Parks. This is Rosa Parks. If you said Rosa Parks, you get a point for our final question. Rosa Parks was an American hero. In 1955, Rosa Parks, who is African-American, was asked to give up a seat on a bus so that a white person could take it. Can you imagine how awful she felt, or how you would feel if you were asked to give up your seat for someone else and the reason that you were asked was prejudice? That must have felt awful. But Rosa Parks stood strong, and that's why she's an awesome woman! All right, so those are our 10 questions, everybody. Before we go, though, we have some other business to attend to, which is, we're gonna advance through those, our quote of the evening. Our quote of the evening is from First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt. You can often change your circumstances by changing your attitude. You can often change your circumstances by changing your attitude. So that's tonight's think about. How does your attitude affect how you feel about your life? I want you to think about it. Maybe talk about it at dinner. Maybe think about it before you go to bed. In this special time that we are experiencing together, being positive and happy together will make all the difference. So if you're stuck in the house and you don't want to be, or you haven't seen your friends in a while, or maybe someone you know has, you know, is not feeling too well, any of those things, how we treat each other will matter right now. and how we behave and how we feel and how we project positivity will matter. So that's tonight's Think About. And now for our riddle. Riddle number two. What has to be broken before you can use it? What has to be broken before you can use it? I don't have the answer. We're going to answer it tomorrow night at the top of the show. You can send your pictures in to me. Just have your parents message me if you want to participate, and we'll grab five of them to show tomorrow night on our home together pals. That's it. So send me your pictures. The riddle once again, what has to be broken before you can use it? Also, I want to say thank you to our doctors, nurses, our ER teams, our delivery workers, and our grocery clerks for all that they're doing. They're making our lives better right now so that we can all make our country healthier. All right, that was Uncle Julie's Kids Trivia Show. Thank you for joining. Have a good night. Let's make some lemonade, people! Love you. And now's the awkward moment where you watch me turn off the FaceTime.